Now, I've spoken about CPU talking to the outside world through copying data in and out from memory. So let's talk about different storage types. Primary storage is the collection of registers that are directly accessible by the CPU. In fact, the primary storage lives in the same location as the CPU does. It lives in the CPU package. And it is an area of memory. A very small number of registers are directly accessible through the CPU. Very, very fast, very good at what they're used for, but again, very restricted because there's only a few of them. Real storage is the area of memory, typically referred to as RAM. It is the random access memory location where programs reside and where the vast majority of your data resides. The CPU does not directly access real storage. Real storage is accessed indirectly through the registers. The CPU asks for information to be pulled into the CPU cache and then perhaps directly into registers where the CPU can then operate on that data. Secondary storage is a type of storage which we normally refer to as our hard disks or our external storage perhaps. It's non-volatile storage. It involves disks, tapes, and any other devices that you can retain data on even after you power a machine down. Remember, primary storage and real storage are all volatile memory. When you turn the power off, the data is all gone. Another thing to consider, too, when you're dealing with PDAs, personal digital assistants, any PDAs are actually going to be using a type of memory that is volatile memory. Now, you may think that, gosh, I've got this PDA, I can carry it around with me for a long time, and I turn it on and turn it off. While that may be true, you still have some battery power that's providing power to the memory. Remember that if you ever lose total power to your PDA, if your battery runs down, then all of the memory, all of your user data is gone. There is some ROM data in there that's been written into chips, but the vast majority of your data is gone. If you're ever doing any forensics work, always remember, you lose the power, you lose the data. Last type of storage is virtual storage. Virtual storage is memory space that can exceed real memory. It involves an area based on page frames so that it looks like to your programs that we can access gigabytes and gigabytes of information, which in reality you probably only have a small fraction of that amount in real storage areas.